What's going on, YouTube? Reasonautics coming at you once again, baby. And I got to do another video on the way home again because today I haven't, I did see the official thing. Nintendo Direct came out today, another Nintendo Direct, straight to the Nintendo fans and the gaming world for that matter, highlighting a bunch of Nintendo Wii U summer releases. It was actually really focused the entire thing, if I'm not mistaken, on Nintendo Wii U, which is great to see. It was great to see Nintendo finally answering some of the critics and basically saying, look, man, y'all been complaining about not having no damn games. Well, here we go. We're about to hit you with all this. And it was just great, man. It was great. It's going to get a lot better. I mean, it wasn't like, oh, my God, amazing. But it was great in the sense that, all right, now we got some quality games coming out on the Wii U that are only going to be on the Wii U. And that's the first step. I know it's going to get a lot better, a lot hotter as it gets closer to E3. But, man, just off the top of my head, just remembering what I saw, and I saw it earlier today, probably at 1 or 2 in the afternoon when I saw it during my lunch break. So if I missed something, I'm sorry. But basically, they opened it up, and they opened it up talking about, if I'm not mistaken, new Luigi U, new Super Luigi U, the downloadable content that's coming out for New Super Mario Bros. U. They gave it a date also. It's coming sometime in July. Basically, man, it's a whole new game, basically. It's a 82, I think, or 83, completely redesigned, brand new levels, starring Luigi. No Mario in the game whatsoever. You can play as Luigi, Yellow Toadstool, Blue Toadstool, and then they added the ability to play as Nabbit, which is that ugly little bunny that just likes to jack stuff from Toad's house that you gotta chase him down in a couple levels throughout New Super Mario Bros. U. You get to play as him, and he's got some special abilities there. In the sense that he doesn't power up whenever he gets mushrooms or, you know, fire flowers or any of that. He don't power up, but he takes on the ability to not take any damage from anybody when he powers up, when he would get the power-ups. So he's got a couple of abilities, and it's just a whole brand new game. Now, they're doing this two ways, which is awesome. They're releasing it as downloadable content sometime in June or July, I'm not sure, because there's two dates. And the reason there's two dates is because they're releasing it as first, right off the bat, as downloadable content for New Super Mario Bros. U. And then they said they realized that some people out there may want to get this, but not necessarily own New Super Mario Bros. U. And if they release it strictly as downloadable content, then you wouldn't be able to get it unless you own New Super Mario Bros. U. So they remedied that by making it a standalone game. About a month or so later, it'll come out as a full-fledged retail game in stores with a badass green case too, which makes me kind of angry in a sense, because I like that case. I'm gonna get it as downloadable content because I'm not gonna wait an extra month. And I already own New Super Mario Bros. U. But at the same time, as a collector, man, I want that case. It's a nice green Wii U case, a full-fledged game and everything. So that was the first thing that they dropped on us. Then they dropped a surprise that I considered a surprise, because I didn't think they were going to make another installment in this franchise, at least not so soon. And that was basically they showed gameplay footage and everything of the new Sonic and Mario at the Olympic Games. And it's awesome, man. I mean, the graphics are beautiful, HD, crisp, clear graphics. A myriad of events with all the different characters there. Different ways to play also. Different ways that it uses the Nintendo Wii U gamepad. And it would just look like a really, really fun game. Like, I have never bought a Sonic and Mario's Olympic Games because that's not my style of game. But this one actually has me looking at it like I'm going to at least rent it. I'm going to at least get my hands on it somehow, some way, so I can determine if I want to buy it, because it looks that fun and that good. So that was a surprise. Then they announced that Nintendo has entered into a worldwide partnership with Sega, which is like a dream come true for old school gamers like myself. I mean, back in the day, Nintendo and Sega were at each other's throats, creating some of the most memorable 16 and 8-bit games. So now they're together in a worldwide partnership. And I read an article about this even before the Nintendo Direct, before the Nintendo Direct came out, talking about how they were going to release, I think it's 7 Wii U games this coming year, which is awesome. The first one was already announced. As Sonic the Lost Land. And for those of you who follow games on the internet and all that, you probably heard something about this over the last day or two. IGN and other sites made articles about how they saw that Sega had trademarked the name Sonic the Lost Land. So that's basically that giveaway that this is the new Sonic. They didn't show any gameplay footage, but Satoru Iwata did say it's a full-fledged 3D action-adventure platformer, the next installment in the Sonic series, and it sounds very exciting, man. To have a Sonic game, a Sonic standalone game that's, of course, done by Sega, but with Nintendo's flair and touch on it through this new partnership, I can only imagine what it's going to be like. So that's another plus. They showed off some more gameplay trailers and a release date for Game & Wario, which looks epically fun. It looks like one of those party games with just mad innovation on how to use a gamepad and all that. And it has a bunch of unlockables too, from what they were saying. It looks really fun. Then they also talked about Pikmin 3. They spent a great deal of time focusing on Pikmin 3 and talking about not just the release date. It's actually been moved up from what I saw, because last we heard was August. Now it's in July 23rd, I think, or something like that. And it has they showed a lot of gameplay. They showed how it's not Olimar anymore, the main character from the first two Pikmins, but it's actually three distinct characters that you can control, all three distinct characters at different times in the game, and with their own squads of Pikmin to help them do what they gotta do. The graphics are just beautiful, stunning HD, clear, crisp. The animations looked beautiful from what they showed. They talked about the different control options. Apparently this game is going to have a plethora of control options as far as how you want to play the game. It does support off-screen play, so you can play the game exclusively on the gamepad. It does use the gamepad, much like the GameCube controller in the first two games, but, you know, with the added bonus of the touchscreen and all the innovation that brings. And also Wiimote and Nunchuk, so a lot of different control options. Man, it just looks great, man. I'm not a Pikmin fan. Never played the first or second one because it just didn't call my attention. But this looks like something that I might, you know, get my hands on as well. They spent a great deal of time talking about that. Let me see. Was there anything else? I mean, they talked about Mario. They talked about Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games. They talked about Sonic the Lost Land. They talked about a new Super Luigi U. They talked about Pikmin 3. I think that's about it, man. They talked a lot about those things. Maybe I'm missing something, but like I said, I'm doing this on the way home off the top of my head. But suffice it to say, Nintendo's starting to answer the critics and basically saying, look, we're coming out with games, and it's starting now. So imagine what the rest of the year is going to get like. Imagine the Nintendo Directs that they're going to have released when it gets to closer to E3, you know, in the next, you know, half a month or so. It's going to be very, very exciting, man. It's a great time to be a Nintendo fan. I know the world wants to paint it a different picture, like it's a horrible time to be a Nintendo fan. Nah, man, it's a great time because we have our new console out. It's getting updated regularly. It's getting all the bugs and quirks out. I mean, yesterday there was a Miiverse update that gave us the added advantage of being able to now not just put screenshots when we're doing original posts, but we can now put screenshots when we're commenting back to someone else's post, which is great because then we get to show them what we're playing. It's not just a one-way street. So that was a great enhancement. And it's just regularly getting updated and getting all patched up and just made more and more efficient and streamlined. And it's been out for about six and a half months now. Now the games are starting to roll in little by little. And as we get through E3 and closer to the holiday season, oh, you already know what's going on. Mario Kart U, Super Smash Bros. 4, a bunch of stuff coming our way, man. I would like to see some surprises, though, in the next couple of weeks. I'm talking about some surprises, like the stuff that we haven't heard about. Like, I want to see Metroid. I want to see Star Fox. I want to see some of the key franchises make a lasting, impactful appearance on this system sooner than later. Also, we had some information leak out yesterday about a dude who goes by the Twitter name of 100-Year-Old Gamer, who apparently is an inside source or developer at Nintendo, and he said that the new 3D Mario that's rumored to be coming in October is going to be insanely massive, bigger than any Mario game before, and unlike anything we've ever seen. Those were his words. So that just brings a whole bunch of excitement. He also said that what Retro's working on, the game that they're going to reveal soon, is something that it's first person. These are the clues he said. He said it's first person. And it's something it's first person, it's futuristic, and it's something that everybody's been wanting them to do. It has a lot of people saying this might be a Metroid Prime game. This might be another Metroid type game. I hope so, but even if it's not, I have full faith in the folks at Retro Studios and Nintendo, especially to pull off something amazing. So there's a lot of things coming, man, down the pipeline for Nintendo Wii U. Y'all just hold on, man. Keep enjoying the system. Keep gaming. And like I said, man, if you haven't seen it, get on your Wii U's right now, or even on your Wii's, or go online on YouTube, or whatever you gotta do, and download that Nintendo Direct and see what they got coming your way, man. I'm sure I left out a couple of details, but like I said, I'm doing this on the fly. God bless y'all. Stay gaming. Peace.